Welcome to the fourth segment in our series on nutrition tools. This segment is covering portion size. What we're going to do is look at some common items you might find in your household and how they compare with portions, just so you can get an idea of what an appropriate portion size is. And all of these are features from the WebMD portion tool. So instead of going over them here in this slide, let's go to WebMD. We're going to start with vegetables, and the most commonly eaten vegetable is a potato, generally in the form of French fries, but it's better if you eat a potato whole, and the more colorful potatoes, the better for you. But a common russet potato or baked potato is going to be about the size of your mouse. And think about the size of your mouse. I'll show you mine and look at it compared to my palm size. Now, if you think about a lot of baked potatoes, they tend to come really big, so they're generally two sizes or more. A cup of broccoli, and this is for many vegetables, especially if they're chopped. Generally, think about the broccoli head or the flower here to be the size of a baseball. If you're going to eat mashed potatoes, think of it about being the size of a light bulb, and this is a half a cup of mashed potatoes. Now let's take a look at leafy greens. One cup is the size of a baseball. You can see this obviously is a little bit bigger, but if you were to pack an actual measuring cup, lightly pack it, it would be about the size of a baseball. But here's the key. Two cups of leafy greens equals one serving of vegetables. And think about it. If you go to a restaurant and you get a side salad, you are likely getting one cup, maybe two cups of leafy greens, maybe a wedge of tomato, and then a ranch dressing on the side, something like that. You might get a little bit of carrot in there. It's unlikely you're getting even two servings of vegetables. You're likely getting one serving of vegetables. So keep that in mind when you go out and what the leafy greens should look like on your plate. Now let's take a look at milk. One serving of cheese is actually 1.5 ounce. And look at this. Look at this compared to the dye, three dye. It's pretty small. I mean, when you eat cheese, you could think about taking off big chunks. And then also think about if you're shredding it, it'll actually end up looking bigger, which is nice. So when you have it in a chunk, it's going to actually be a lot smaller. So 1.5 ounces is going to be one serving of cheese. Again, one cup of yogurt would be a serving. This is about an 8 ounce container, the size of a baseball. If you're going to eat frozen yogurt or ice cream, think about it being the size of a light bulb. Now this is a half a cup of ice cream is one serving. Now it doesn't mean you only should eat one serving. That's not what serving sizes are designed for. They're designed for you to compare nutrients in different products based on a standard serving size. Let's go to grains, and I'll take the bagel. Now think about a bagel and the size that you might get at your favorite bagel shop, and they are supersized. They're generally this big. They're just that big around, and they really should be about the size of a can of tuna. And that's pretty small. If you think about a can of tuna, it's going to be a little bit more like this. So a bagel, that is one bagel, and that's going to be your serving size. A biscuit is similar to a hockey puck. A slice of bread. Now, I have to laugh at this cassette tape, because if you're in your 20s, you don't even know what a cassette tape is. So it's hard for you to use this as a comparison. But a cassette tape is going to be about this size right here. Bigger than the palm of my hand, but not so big that it's larger than my fingers. So your bread really needs to fit in one slice of bread into about this size right here. A lot of breads are much bigger than that. And that's just one slice. We usually have two servings of bread if you're going to have a sandwich. A cup of cereal, and you'll notice on the packaging, it's usually 3/4 cups a lot of times for cereals. So sometimes 3/4 to 1 cup is going to be a serving size for cereal, and that's about the size of a baseball. And let's jump up to cooked rice, and this is about the size of a light bulb. And remember, a light bulb's pretty small, so that's a half a cup. That's going to be a serving. When you do your diet study and when you're recording your diet and entering it, make sure that you are putting cooked rice as opposed to uncooked rice, depending on how you measure it. And that's important because if you're putting a half a cup of uncooked rice, that's going to create about 3 half-cup servings. And that'll throw off a lot of your diet study, a lot of the values. Okay, let's jump to some meat and fish and proteins. So we have beans and nuts in here. Nuts are very calorie dense. They do have a lot of protein, they have a lot of fat. So the serving size is generally about 1/4 cup. Doesn't mean you should only eat 1/4 cup, but that's generally the serving size because it's a calorie equivalent to other serving sizes. And this is about the size of a golf ball, so pretty small. And they say about 23 almonds. Now, 3 ounces of meat, no matter what the meat is a typical serving size. Sometimes we say 3 to 4 ounces. It should look about the size of a deck of cards. A deck of cards is pretty small. And if you're going out to a restaurant, you'll notice that generally you're going to get a portion that's probably about 10 ounces or so. So you're really getting about 3 servings of that meat as your serving size, as your portion size. And again, it's not that you only have to consume 3 ounces of meat. It's just that that is your kind of measurement, your comparison base. For beans, you want to have about 1/2 cup as a serving size, and that's similar to the size of a light bulb. Chicken, exactly the same, 3 ounces. A lot of the chickens are going to come, if you buy them in a package, they usually come as 1 pound. So that's 4 servings of chicken in your one package. Fish, 3 ounces, is generally a little bit lighter, so we think of it more like a checkbook. Again, a lot of you may not even use a checkbook, so that may not be a good comparison. But it is going to be larger than a deck of cards. Fruit, medium-sized fruit such as an apple is going to look like a baseball. A medium-sized banana is going to look like a pencil. 1/2 cup of blueberries, again, all the 1/2 cup is always going to be about the size of a light bulb. And let's go to some of the dried fruit. So generally for fruit sizes, it's going to be 1/2 cup is going to be a serving size, unless it's a dried fruit, and then it's going to be 1/4 cup because that's condensed, they have less water, it's going to be smaller. So then, I know this is hard to see, but think of it about the size of a golf ball. So a tablespoon of butter, and they have a poker chip here, but if you've never gambled, you may not know what a poker chip looks like. So a little bigger than 1/4. So pretty small, 1 serving of butter. And same thing, a tablespoon of mayonnaise is going to be a little bigger than 1/4. And olives. Olives definitely have a lot of fat in them. So that's going to be about 5 medium olives. So sweets. This, and I think this is a great example here, is we have a brownie and it's the size of dental floss. So think about that. Think about some of the brownies that you might pick up if you're ordering a coffee and then you get their brownie, maybe midday snack at your coffee shop. And how big are those brownies? They're usually the size of my hand. Well, I haven't seen dental floss that large. Dental floss is about this big. So keep that in mind, particularly with desserts. And let's jump up to also 1 ounce of chocolate is a good comparison is with the dental floss. If you're having a cinnamon roll, which some people would eat for breakfast, it compares to a hockey puck. And same when we look at a cookie and think of it about being, you know, a little larger than $0.50 or 2/4. So again, one small cookie is going to be probably smaller than the palm of my hand. And lastly, we'll go to ice cream. We covered this before. 1/2 cup is a serving of ice cream. And that is it for portion sizes.